And I want us to go to Colossians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. Colossians 2, verse 8 and 9. And it says this: beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the tradition of men. In other words, they come with a custom rather than the word of God, according to the basic principles of this world, and not according to Christ. Now, I don't want to focus on that, but not according to Christ. The next verse is important. For in him dwells all the fullness, in Jesus Christ, dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. I want you to see that Jesus Christ is our example. When we get into the word, we see what Jesus did, what Jesus taught. How did Jesus handle situations? Because Jesus Christ is our ultimate example, and he's the example of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I want you to look at this verse very carefully. For in him dwells the fullness of the Godhead bodily. All of the Godhead is in Jesus Christ's body, his physical body. So that you can get an example and a feel and a character of who God is. And so this morning I want us to really look at that. Because our pursuit should be, Lord Jesus, let me get a revelation of who you are. Let me understand who you are. Let me really get a grip of what you were teaching. Let me get a grip of what your heart was for people. And so having said that, I want us to go to Matthew chapter 9, verse 11. Okay, and I want you to see this. When the Pharisees, now remember who the Pharisees were. These are the religious folk, right? These are the guys that just stuck to the letter of the law. You know, what is right is right and wrong is wrong. And they understood the laws of Moses, those 600 odd laws. They knew how to implement them. I'll tell you what, they were scholars, okay? But the Pharisees said to his disciples, Jesus' disciples, why does your teacher eat with the tax collectors and sinners? Why is this rabbi, this potential teacher of God's word, mixing with the unsaved and sinners? They could not understand that. Well, let me tell you something, that's Jesus' heart. Jesus' heart is that all come to know him. And so I want to tell you right now, saints, we need to mix with those who need Jesus. We need to mix with those who have an issue in their life. We need to mix with people who are not the most kosher that you might not want to bring home. I want to tell you right now, God wants us to make a difference wherever we go. And so if somebody needs Jesus Christ, they need to see Jesus Christ in you. And how do they do that? When you are your brother's keeper. If you help somebody, they then look to you as somebody they can trust and somebody they can respect. So I want to encourage us as we come up to this festive season. All right, don't get into a holy idol with just Christians. Go and find somebody that you could just be a friend to. All right, even if they are a sinner. All right, even if they are doing things that you don't consider correct. But just be an example. Show them that Christians can love people. I want to tell you right now, it's the love of God. It's the goodness of God that leads to repentance. The Bible says it. The goodness of God. How is a sinner going to see goodness unless a Christian shows him? And so I want to challenge us over this season. If you've got some family members or you've got some friends, all right, that are acquaintances that are coming around or you're going to meet this season, just don't criticize them. Just love them. And allow God to deal with them. And as you start praying for them, the Holy Spirit's going to deal with them. Because I want to tell you right now, there are so many in need of Jesus Christ. As I taught a few days ago, sin and darkness has got a power that's attached to it. If you can get somebody born again, it breaks that power off their lives. Their lives will never be the same. And so this season, I want us to really focus on just loving people, being kind to people, okay, being good to people. Don't criticize them. Don't judge them. Because God died, sent Jesus Christ to die for those sinners. But we have to be that example in Jesus' name. And so this morning, to be able to do that, you need to have a revelation of Jesus yourself. You need to understand who Jesus was and understand his love for the sinners. And so this morning, as we take communion, I'm going to ask God to reveal who Jesus is to us. Because the Bible says if we understand Jesus, we will understand the Godhead. If we understand Jesus, we will understand what God has for us. We've got an example in Jesus' name. Folks, we have an example. So, on the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and broke it and he said, "This is my body that was broken for you. Take in remembrance of me." He took the cup and he said, "This is my blood that was shed. Take in remembrance of me." The body was broken for our physical, emotional healing. The blood was shed for our salvation, protection, and provision. Let's pray together. Lord, I thank you right now that you love us so much, and we ask you please to forgive us of any wrongdoing, any wrong action, motive, deed, intent, Lord, and word. Father, I ask you please to forgive us. Jesus, we thank you for paying the price at Calvary, so that we can have the Holy Spirit living in us. But Lord, right now I ask you, Lord, that firstly, you will make yourself so real to us. Lord, that we will get a revelation of who you are, but most of all, that we will get a revelation of how much you love the human race. And Lord, right now I pray that you're going to help us to not criticize, be negative, and judge people, but God, that you're going to give us the grace to be merciful and to be good and kind. Lord, I thank you that the goodness of the Lord leads to repentance. I thank you, Lord, that the goodness of the Lord is going to change people's lives. I pray right now, Lord, that you're going to lead us over this festive season. And Lord, that we will be the example that you've asked us to be, and we will portray Jesus Christ at every turn. In Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said, amen and amen. Let's partake together. Lord, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for a supernatural healing in our bodies. We resist every form of sickness in Jesus' name. And Lord, right now we worship you, we honor you, we thank you, Lord, that we are healed in the name of Jesus. By your stripes we were healed. Your body was broken for us, and Lord, we claim that price in Jesus' name. And Lord, we command every single bit of sickness to leave our bodies right now. We command our bodies healed in the mighty name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen and amen. Well, folks, I want to encourage you this morning. I want to just say to you, well done. Thank you for hanging in there. 2020 has been an interesting year. But I tell you what, spiritually, so many of us have grown. So many of us have got into the Word. So many of us have changed things and we've aligned things. What Satan meant for evil, God is turning around for good, and he's actually equipping the saints. We are actually getting the body of Christ ready to sit down and create this umbrella across our nation. And I know, like I know, that God is busy with something awesome. So I want to encourage you. Go out and just be an example. But I'm going to pray this morning that you are going to have a supernatural rest today, and that you are going to be revitalized in your body, and that you are ready for this last stretch in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray right now for every single person who's working hard and who's running hard. I pray for energy, vitality. Father, I pray for wisdom. Lord, that even if they are tired, Father, I pray you'll give them the creative ideas. Lord, I thank you for every single person who's been faithful to establish altars in their businesses. Lord, I pray right now that you are going to move in a supernatural way in every single person's life. Father, I pray for Holy Ghost rest. that when they put their head down to rest, they will rest. Lord, I thank you right now that you are building them up and getting them ready to do what they need to do in Jesus' name. And Lord, I thank you right now for a supernatural blessing and a restoration in their physical bodies. Lord, that they are ready for this next round in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen and amen. Well, folks, I just want to remind you that at 10 o'clock this morning, we've got our Afrikaans service, our children's church. We are running it in three segments. It's about the Christmas story. I want to please encourage you to get the children connected. All right, it is on Father's Heart Kids. If somebody can type it up for me, Father's Heart Kids Facebook page. And I want you please to go and check English and Afrikaans, and so that they could go and get the stories. Because I think it's really important that the next generation understand what Christmas is about. All right, it's really important. So please, I'm asking you to help us and assist us. Get that to the children in Jesus' name. And then at 6 o'clock tonight, I've got the English service. Okay, 6 o'clock tonight. And I'm going to be ministering at 6 p.m. And also, the children's church is on. Okay, so that you can, the English and the Afrikaans is on in the morning. But you can watch it in the evening if you'd like to, if the parents are watching and the children can watch that. All right, folks, we're going to pray right now. We're going to release the declaration over every single person. In Jesus' name, I declare by faith that I walk in divine favor. I have preferential treatment. I have supernatural increase. I have prominence. I have petitions granted. I have policies and rules changed. Battles won that I did not have to fight. All because of the blessing and the favor of God on my life.